In this video, we will explain how performance analytics complements reporting, and we will take you on a tour of the components of performance analytics, including key performance indicators, scorecards, dashboards, and widgets. So how does performance analytics complement reporting? Reports provide a snapshot. Performance analytics provide snapshots over time. Reporting can be ad hoc, whereas we collect data over time at regular intervals to use performance analytics to its full potential. Data collected at regular intervals can provide us with indications of trends. Now, let's look at the components that we can use in performance analytics to analyze our data. We'll start with key performance indicators, or KPIs, which are the metrics we can use to evaluate performance. Defining the right set of metrics will enable you to drive performance improvements in your processes across the organization. We can view our key performance indicators in a scorecard, which provides a quick overview of the performance of all selected KPIs for a given category, much like a stock portfolio. The top of the scorecards page allows us to view scorecards by categories: best, worst, improved, degraded, and all. The list settings menu, accessed via the gear icon, allows us to set filters to change the list view. Let's turn on the bullet chart and direction options to see them in the list. And the bullet and direction columns display. The direction column shows us what direction we want the score to trend. The bullet column populates in the scorecard list when we set a target, which we can do in the detailed scorecard. To open a detailed scorecard, we can click on the scorecard name. To set the target, we first select a start date and then enter a target value. Now, when we return to our scorecard page, the bullet column displays a chart. The current score will also turn red or green to indicate whether it is above or below target. In our example, the current score of 72.83% is above the target we selected. Because the desired direction is minimized, the score is red to indicate that we are above the target. Let's take another look at what's available in the detailed scorecard. We can change the date range display by adjusting the time slider underneath the chart. If we want to see more detail about a particular data point, we can click it to display the related information within its context. This allows us to further analyze, for example, by drilling down into the records. And we can also add a comment for a particular date. In this case, we want to note that the number of incidents is high. Because this value seems so high, we could apply a time series to smooth out the weekend effect or other noise that may appear within the data. Regardless of which time series we apply, the data still shows an upward trend for this score. So let's look in the tabs for more information. The breakdown tab allows us to examine data broken down by a category. By default, performance analytics provides priority, category, assignment group, state, and age. With the premium version, you can create and add your own breakdowns. The records tab allows us to view all of the records associated with that scorecard. Note that this tab is only available if the indicator is not a formula and the collect records option is active for this indicator. The comments tab allows us to view all comments entered for that scorecard. The more info tab displays the formula that calculates the score, if applicable to this indicator. It also displays the description of the indicator, how often it is updated, the last time it was updated, and in what direction the score should be trending. Now let's take a look at dashboards. A dashboard is like a multi-tabbed homepage where you analyze and interact with visualizations of indicator scores, called widgets. Widgets allow visualizations of multiple indicators on a single chart in order to visualize multiple score sources. This open incidents widget displays scores from three different sources. We can choose from a number of different visualizations to best display our data as a breakdown, list, score, or time series. In our example, the number of open incidents, not updated in the last 5 days, is on the rise, as we can see in the widget on the dashboard. We will drill down into the detailed scorecard from the chart to further analyze what is happening. By clicking on the records tab, we can see the individual records and view them within a chart. We can see that a large number of requests have come into the system, so this would be worth investigating further. We can drill down even further and look at the requests exclusively. As we've shown here, performance analytics allows us to see trends in our data. Trends in our data, in turn, provide us with insights that we can use to drive our activities based on what we're seeing in our indicator scores. For more information, please consult our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.